enable.
Welcome to Inspirational Brands Make in India. Through this series, we explore the growth trajectories of business leaders and companies that are contributing significantly to the government's Make in India mission.
The cement industry plays a crucial role in the growth and development of a nation, and one company that's working relentlessly towards building sustainable infrastructure is Orient Cement. Founded in 1979, the company has a legacy based on strength and trust. A part of the CK Birla Group, Orient Cement has today emerged as one of the fastest growing and leading cement manufacturers in India, with a production capacity of 8 million tons per annum. To promote high quality and strong concrete, the company offers various products under the brand name of Birla A1 Premium Cement and newly launched Birla A1 StrongCrete.
I think what we are very excited right now is to have launched a new cement in India, which perhaps is the strongest and we believe the best cement that the Indian markets have today. We branded it Birla A1 StrongCrete, and that's a new launch. It's still not being rolled out all across our plants, but we are very excited about the brand. So that's the new addition, the new baby in our basket to carry in the product portfolio.
Orient Cement has three state-of-the-art manufacturing plants located in Devapur in Telangana, Nashirabad in Jalgaon, Maharashtra, and Chittapur in Karnataka. With an aim to provide unmatched quality, strength, and durability, Orient Cement is constantly innovating to create high-grade products that meet the changing needs of consumers.
It has always been our focus area that we have strived towards seeing that we provide the best quality product and value to our customers and stakeholders. We have a great connect with our channel partners. There's a strong strength of channel partner which we have, along with a good, robust network of logistic service providers, which actually has helped us in building a very strong and robust distribution network in the urban, semi-urban, and the rural market.
Having started his career with State Bank of India in 1976, the Managing Director and CEO of Orient Cement, Deepak Khetarpal, is an industry veteran who bears valuable expertise, skills and experience. Having served at the helm of various organizations, Deepak specializes in retail, consumer orientation and brand positioning, amongst other business verticals. He joined Orient Cement in 2012 and has since laid a strong foundation for the company's growth and success. With his strategic and strong business orientation, Deepak has played a key role in establishing the company as a strong player in the cement industry.
And now I'm in conversation with the man himself, the MD and CEO of Orient Cement, Deepak Khetarpal. Deepak, welcome to the show. Thank you so much for joining us here today.
Thank you. Thank you for having me here.
Well, you've had an illustrious career of over 40 years and of course a lot of milestones in there in that career. You joined Orient Cement in 2012. That was also the year that the company demerged from Orient Paper and Industries. So how did that particular move really change the growth story of the company?
Sure. It's actually... If you look at the history of the company, we obviously started in 1982 in a very, very small manner, capacity less than 500,000 ton. And over a period of time from 1982 till 2012, when the company got demerged from Orient Paper, we had risen to about 5 million tons of capacity.
Right.
And all those expansions that happened largely were in small measures. And by 2012, the board of directors realized that cement business, given the overall demand growth, given the size of the industry, it needs to grow faster. So with the demerger in 2012, it largely was an opportunity to provide all the investors a pure play cement company based on which our next growth trajectory was to be built. And when we got demerged, soon after that, we had actually put out our ambition very clearly that we want to be a relevant player in the Indian company. And relevant player typically in the Indian context means unless you are 15 to 20 million tons of capacity, you are too small in the Indian cement sector, which you know today is nearing almost 500 million tons. And the ambition was that we will actually grow to be 15 million tons by 2020. That's something that we agreed to do in 2012 when we got demerged.
And how far ahead are you on that?
Yeah, we actually have made some significant progress on that. In 2013 itself, we started construction of a 3 million tons additional greenfield capacity in Karnataka. So very quickly by 2015, I think September 2015, we had commissioned a new greenfield plant. I think in record time of construction and also in record cost in terms of how effectively we built that capacity. So 8 million tons got done in 2015. And thereafter, while we were planning the other things, we also came across another opportunity that we saw in the market of growing through acquisition, which was again supposed to be part of our strategy only. It was not that it was not thought of. So we got into a transaction. First, obviously, we went around doing a due diligence, this, that. And in 2017, we made the announcement that we were going to buy some of the assets from Jaiprakash Associates,
right,
which would have taken us to 12 million tons. Now, unfortunately, that transaction finally didn't go through and we lost some time. So what we've started doing is that after, let's say, the deal got called off 31st of May this year,
right,
we obviously started planning for what we call the Plan B. Right, and Plan B included organic growth. Organic growth can happen only in plants where you have enough limestone reserves. And fortunately for us, both our plants in Telangana, in the place called Devapur, and the other new plant which we commissioned in 2015, like I said, in Chittapur in Karnataka, both these plants have enough limestone, enough infrastructure for us to go for brownfield expansion.
So India is today the second largest producer of cement in the world, and of course, Orient Cement making a contribution there as well. But what will it take for us to beat China, really? And in the global arena, what are the biggest challenges that perhaps the government needs to focus on and fix at the earliest?
The key drivers, as I said, are domestic demand, which has come up. But despite that, even today, the total industry utilization of capacity is still around 70%. So we still have a lot of unused capacity. So when you said what does the government need to do, I think government is doing enough to promote their own investment, but the industrial investment needs to come back. As we know, private investment today in the economy is at a very, very low level, right? In the industrial, to add any capacity to in any industry. Housing sector, in the major urban areas, no new construction activity is coming up. And that's what is, I think, holding us down a little bit. The moment housing industry picks up again, and the governments keep up their momentum of their investment in infrastructure, yeah, I think we'll be back to higher capacity utilization. And people like us who are today announcing our, let's say, expansion of capacity in the plans, it is an anticipation of that demand going up. And we don't want to be lagging behind in that. So
it's been a couple of years of the Make in India initiative. As a manufacturer, do you find any great change at the grassroots level?
Well, there's been tremendous change. I must tell you that. Because in terms of getting approvals and all, the processes are a lot smoother. We are able to almost predict how much time it will need from our side to get all those approvals where they're required also. In other areas, if you look at it, this kind of support we are getting from all the policies, both at the central government level and within the state level. For example, I told you we were able to complete our Karnataka project. It was with enough support from the state governments and from the local administration. Same thing in Telangana. The Department of Industries and Commerce have promised complete support in whichever way to help our investment of nearly 2,000 crores that we promised in this brownfield expansion. Mm-hmm. So we're getting all that support in terms of setting up the industry. The major support that we now are waiting for the markets to pick up.
Right.
Yeah.
And as soon as they kick in, we want to be ready with our capacity.
Okay, so on that note, we're going to take a short break right now, but stay with us because the conversation with Deepak Khetarpal of Orient Cement continues on the other side. You're watching our special series, Inspirational Brands Make in India.
Keeping pace with the changing landscape of the manufacturing sector, Orient Cement has built a business that's cost-effective with systematic operational efficiencies and streamlined processes, thereby making it a leading player in the cement industry.
having produced it at the right cost, it's also important that you transport it into the markets at a competitive rates. Logistics is 30%. So we clearly identify our core markets, which is within 300 kilometers from the plants, and we make sure that most of our business happens there. There's also a segment which returns higher money, which is your trade segment. We make sure that there's a strong focus on increasing the trade, and the non-trade, which is basically the B2B business, there we took a strategic call of creating a key account management, which is paying good dividends. Sourcing of coal is an important part of the business, fuel, coal and petco. So there's a tremendous focus on that, at a much senior level resources engaged on that to make sure that we do the sourcing at the right cost.
Build sustainably and be a valued partner in progress is what our vision is. Largely what it means is that yes, we will grow, we'll build the company, but we will be an organization which is a conscious organization, which is a conscientious organization. We want always, we've been doing that and we'll keep doing it, give a lot more back to society than we take from it, whether it's on the natural resources or talent or whatever else we do.
Spread over 193 acres, the Devapur plant is the first integrated cement unit of Orient Cement, located in Mancherial district in Telangana. The plant began its cement production in 1982 and has a current capacity of up to 3 million tons per annum. It is equipped with state-of-the-art manufacturing capabilities and online quality control that are ideal for efficient product manufacturing. The Devapur plant is the first cement plant in Telangana to be ISO 14001 certified by DNV in recognition of its outstanding environment management system. It caters to markets in Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh and Karnataka. Employing 585 people, this plant has created skilled, semi-skilled and unskilled jobs for people residing in surrounding areas. Emphasizing on the culture of inclusive growth and sustainable development, Orient Cement offers facilities for the welfare of its employees and their families by providing access to education, healthcare, and more.
Welcome back to Inspirational Brands Make in India, a special series on which we put the focus on those companies that are contributing significantly to the government's Make in India mission. On the show today, we are in Hyderabad and I'm in conversation with Deepak Khetarpal, MD and CEO of Orient Cement. Deepak, your company has won several accolades as far as energy efficiency is concerned. So what are the sort of processes that you've put in place for that, and how do you ensure that your plants are all clean, green and eco-friendly?
Industries like cement, whatever we produce, we're actually consuming natural resources which are not replaceable. And we at this company are very proud of the fact that every single one of us, when we are consuming a resource, we are actually thinking of resource conservation for the next generation, rather than thinking in terms of efficiency and how much cost I can save. Because that can motivate people, that can inspire people to a certain extent. But when they relate to the big cause of saying resources on this earth are finite and we need to be using the resources as frugally as possible, I think that's been our win.
The other thing that Orient is very well known for is excellence in quality. And given that it is over four decades old, quality has been pretty consistent over the decades. What sort of processes are put in place for that?
Every batch of cement, the way it is tested for quality and consistency, not just in the, one of the key things we also believe is what you, consistency of quality. It's not that we have to give the minimum quality as per BIS standard. We have defined our quality standards for Birla Even brand, which has to be maintained at all costs. And we monitor what is the standard deviation. Every batch, how much does it do away from the mean that we have established? And the effort is not to establish quality, is to eliminate the deviation from it. Which is like I said, it's an approach to the business. And we believe that our goodwill in the market is all related to the consistent experience that the customers has when using our product, our cement.
So tell us a little bit about the product portfolio that you have at Orient Cement and a little bit about your manufacturing facilities as well as current production capacity.
As on date, Orient Cement is a pure play cement company. We are not into other adjacent lines that many other companies have gone. We are into building products areas, in another company of the group. And within cement, the product portfolio actually is just two, either it's blended cement or unblended cement. The unblended cement is called OPC, cement which is consumed in large infrastructure projects. And PPC is blended cement with blended with fly ash. And they can be also a mix or blend with steel slag, which then it starts calling getting called PSC, is Portland, cement with slag inside.
And where are your manufacturing plants located at the moment?
Manufacturing plants, right now there is one integrated plant in the state of Telangana in a place called Devapur, which is in district material towards northern part of Telangana state. That is where we do clinkerization, which is an intermediate product in the cement industry, and cement grinding. Devapur plant is also supported by a separate grinding unit in Jalgaon in Maharashtra, which enables us to cater to our customers who are in the catchment area in Maharashtra. So that is a pure grinding unit, it's not an integrated plant. And then, as I mentioned earlier, in Karnataka, in a place called Chetapur in district Gulbarga, we constructed a new plant, 3 million tons capacity, again catering to markets in Karnataka and the neighboring states of Maharashtra and Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. So total 8 million tons divided into these three plants.
Technology is transforming pretty much every business in the country and around the world. Digital transformation is something that many companies are embracing. At Orient Cement, what sort of technology transformations are happening?
I'm proud to say we are part of the industry in India, which perhaps technologically the most advanced in the world. In terms of how efficient we are, in terms of the equipment, we use hugely intelligent equipment which generate data which is monitored through what we call the central control room. So sitting in one control room, you can have your finger on the pulse of every part of the plant which is built over 300 to 500 acres of land.
Right.
Second part of technology transformation that we talk about are the transformations which are in the non-technical or non-production side, right? Which includes logistics, which includes our sales effort, or the way we sort of service our customers. Then obviously there are reporting requirements and let's say what we need to do for our investors. The third part, you see, the digital technology can be efficiencies, service improvement. Another very important area for digital deployment really is to be able to really understand the market dynamics, how to add more customers to this thing, how to spot those customers. On that, I would say we are not where we want to be. A lot of data analytics work that we need to be sort of doing and drawing conclusions from, drawing support, that work is now under implementation.
Cement is a labor-intensive industry as well. Is it challenging to find affordable and skilled labor?
It is challenging more from the perspective of the fact that cement plants are always located in remote areas.
Right.
They depend on their livelihood on the cement plants. So, from running schools for their children who grow up to then join and become our workforce, to providing them training, it's all an on-the-job function. We're actually talking to various governments. If we can get some support from them in terms of proactively skill building so that by the time we set up our plants, we get some people who are already knowing. But largely, on the labor side, the skills are all built on the job by us.
And but currently your plants are located mostly in the south only. Any plans of moving anywhere outside to other geographies, or and why the south particularly?
One of the key things we have to remember is that cement capacity can be built only when there is limestone available. All right. As we speak, we have a line of sight on limestone reserves in Rajasthan, where we had an old mining lease which has been under a bit of dispute with the state government. We're trying to resolve that. So that's one opportunity that we definitely are carrying on the back of our minds to diversify away from here. The other opportunity would be whenever we're looking at an acquisition, in all probability, we want to buy a company with limestone reserves in an area which is not within the southern part of India.
Right.
So that will be our strategy to diversify markets and de-risk the business.
All right. Going forward, what are your short-term as well as long-term goals for Orient Cement? Where do you want to take it from here?
Clearly, very clearly defined goals. 15 million tons of capacity. Utilization should remain above 80% and the EBITDA should, and we know when the cycles recover, should get to about 900 to 1,000 rupees a ton of EBITDA, which is feasible, and that's what we will keep chasing. Beyond that, beyond midterm, after 2022-23, the ambition remains that we must remain, try and build capacity which is roughly 5% of the industry's capacity. The only constraint will be our capacity to acquire limestone mines, our capacity to attract enough investment that we keep making, and we'll keep growing.
Well, all the best to you and Orient Cement. Deepak, it's been a pleasure talking to you. Thank you so much for joining us on the show.
Thank you. Thanks for being here and thanks for listening.
Well, with that, it's a wrap of this special episode of Inspirational Brands Make in India. Hope you enjoyed those insights into the journey of Orient Cement. We'll be back next time with another inspiring tale of business success from corporate India. Thanks for joining us. Goodbye.
Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.